a dream. It's an XVW and they're gonna be thrilling you. They get hardcore, blood covering the floor. They take it out of the ring, they the wrestling kings. When it comes to a show, be ready for the bows, cause they ain't slow, sit right in the front row, cause it gets crunk. No.
Trying to follow, we will do our best to keep this on camera. As Nate still hit, oh, he's holding them for the fans. Big chop. Uh-oh. Odd Bodies owner needs to get a chop in as well. Firing back now. His wings is rammed into the table. Going to the front. Fans are chanting outside. He won't be able to see anything if they go outside. Well, we can barely keep him on camera here. Hopefully our mobile camera is getting a good shot of all this. It is difficult to see from my vantage point. Two of them fighting now at the bar. Just don't waste any of that good liquor. I mean, cheap liquor, yeah, but none of the good liquor, please. Jet is down on the mat, or on the floor, I should say. We're way in the front of Odd Bodies. Well, where's Wings gonna bring them? Coming close, I thought they were coming closer to the ring area. And we'll have action restored in a moment. Finally on the far side of the ring. Swing's about to drop, yes! Drop Jet on that apron. Right on the frame of the ring. It's the most unforgiving part. But only gets a two count for his troubles. I'm still surprised at the number of fans that Jaden Jet actually has. I've never seen a Jaden Jet fan before. I might have to interview one of these individuals and find out exactly who they are and what planet they come from. Times into that top turnbuckle. Jet looks like he's about out of it. He's about to take the chair. That's where he's most comfortable. One, two. Anyone will mistake him for Booker T, but both on the outside. Going to do a suplex on the outside. He went for it. Tried twice, but it got blocked by Jet. Oh! And he reversed it, and Wings landed on that apron. Well, I guess payback's from earlier. Rice walking around looking a little frustrated. Jet not really taking the punishment that he had hoped. Actually doing quite well for himself. Looking, oh wow, drops him right into the table at ringside, the VIP table. He's got one of those cones. What's he gonna do? Oh, he's pressing it like he's strong. Those things don't weigh very much. Nonetheless, he clobbers him right in the kisser. As they fight back toward, well, he can't seem to make up his mind if he's going toward the front of the building or coming back to the ring. I did not hear that this was false count anywhere. So if you're going to win, you're going to have to come back to the ring. And they do so. Uh-oh, chair coming into play. Looks like Jet's going back for another one. Not sure what he has in mind. They each have one now. Perhaps this could have been a mistake on Jet's part. Say what? What in? Oh, a little punch off. Well, neither one of these are the heaviest of hitters. This is gonna be who can take the most. I'm not really sure who I would give the nod to here. Give the advantage to. They seem like they're about even Steven thus far. Maybe rethinking the strategy. Yeah. Jet says he had enough of that. Nice old fashioned classic body slam in the center of the ring. Now looks. Wow! Elevated DDT, almost a brain buster, right into that chair. One, two, but only a two count. And Jet is frustrated. He wants this match over with in the worst way. Setting up a chair, what's he got in mind this time? Powerbomb, it looks like. Hurricane Rana by Nate Wings. Well, that's one way to get out of it. Springboard off the ropes. Tornado DDT into the chair. For the cover, hooks the leg. Oh! So close, so close. Wow, did you hear that crowd? Everybody thought he had him. Wings quickly setting up the chairs. He's got something in mind. Apparently he needs another one. grabbing a couple more chairs. Throws him into the ring. Don't waste too much time. I'm not sure what he's planning on, but two more. He wants two more chairs. Fans are grabbing chairs. Oh, no, we can't have this. Wait a minute. He's got six chairs now, and Jet's starting to recover. This could be a mistake. When Jet was going to use the chair, that backfired earlier. Both men standing on the chairs. What? Those chairs are not very stable. Try to get him up in a fireman's carry. As Jet goes to the eyes. Jet's going for it now. Oh, wow! RKO on the chair. I'm surprised those chairs managed to catch Jet. And he got him. Nate's neck to snap that much harder. As you heard, not only the winner of this match, he is the winner of the Best of Five series. You know he'll be bragging about this for a long, long time. Bryce T, thinking his hardcore stipulation would work out in Nate Wing's favor, but it did not. Look at that piece of garbage. Had to be helped to the back. He certainly doesn't look like a winner.
Jacobs into the corner. went for a chop himself, but this time,
Jacobs was...
Shade to the Three Stooges. And now both men to the outside. Big headbutt by Danner. There's a two ball on the outside. And the referee's following. This was not announced as a false count anywhere match. I don't know why the ref's following him. Unless there's something I'm unaware of, as the two are fighting up towards stage and close to our broadcast area. Hey, what's he doing there? Oh, come on! Well, it is no disqualification. That's pretty much taking advantage of it.
Come on, guys, get in the ring.
Several right hands by Ganger. And a headbutt by Jacobs. Oh, and another one. Wow. I could hear that one all the way up here.
Somebody put your foot up.
Somebody put your foot up. Anybody, he said. Little paybacks. Oh, you can't get any closer to the action than that. Two of them fighting all the way to the front of the building of odd bodies. Oh, using that chair. I hope DATV is getting a good shot at this. Oh, the chair's setting him up again. No, he's not using the chair. A little insulting, however. And another headbutt by Jacobs. Both individuals have been very successful with that headbutt thus far. As Jacobs just continues to beat on him. It's tough to see from our broadcast position. What's he doing now? Wait a minute! Wait a minute! Slaps him right on top! Wow! I don't know. I hope.
What's happening, big time?
I hope we don't get any lawsuits from that one. Calling for help from somebody. Now, trying to get back in the ring, but Ganger put a halt to it, at least momentarily. Now where is he going? Is he having a, is that a hammer?
Let's go up to the ring and Daniel Blevins. Wants a timeout. There's no timeout in wrestling. The cowardice being shown by this individual. Ganger says that's long enough. Oh, wow. Low blow, but perfectly legal. Caught him with just the heel of that boot. I don't know, in a street fight, he probably should have come in wearing cowboy boots. He could have really knocked him out with that. And now a chair. And Ganger's just taking it, saying, come on, what else you got? Down goes Ganger. Nate brought that chair specifically to do this, to use it on Ganger. Down for the cover. Only a one count. Look at the way the referee looked at him. One, that's all you got. Oh, he wants to add him up. He said it's two now. It doesn't work that way, Virgil. He says his grandpa isn't here. Well, I've never met his grandpa, so I don't know. I don't think it's Die Hard Tomicline. I don't think they're related. And now again, utilizing the chair is Nate McLean. Oh, wow. Right under the chin. That could do serious damage to the esophagus. Also cause you to break some teeth. And now what's he looking for? Trying to find something. What is that? Is that a fork? Oh, nice suplex. Nate still has that fork or whatever it is. Oh, right on the back of the head. Fans chanting, we want blood. Uh-oh. now Ganger has that fork. Throws the chair out. I think he might be looking to give us blood. Oh, he's got, oh, look at that. Look at he's doing, just jamming that fork. Oh, man. Unbelievable. Now, what's Ganger looking for now? Oh, he's looking at it. Oh, look at that! Kryptonite is just pouring! Get a good shot of that kisser. And Nate crawling around. Look, the fans getting a good look. Oh, look out. Here he comes with a chair. Right across the back. And McLean trying to crawl away. Referee telling everybody to back up. Unfortunately, I can't see what's going on from my vantage point. Who's ever seen a virgin get hurt? Well, I heard that. And again with a chair. And the super virgin is indeed hurting. I wish I could be right there to see what's going on, because no doubt Ganger is doing a number. Oh, look at that! Series of right hands to McLean. We've got a cameraman right there catching all this, fortunately. And now they're coming back to the ring area. Oh! Well, I guess somebody had to hold the chair. Oh! Nate tried to block it best he could, but I don't even think he could see what direction it was coming from. He's got that blood flowing into his eyes. You can't see too well. Oh, into the chair. And now Ganger using that trash can. McLean has had very little offense since the beginning of this match. Is that, that's a cheese grater. Oh, for crying out loud, the guy's already bleeding. Some blood of his own if he can. I don't know if he's really going in the right direction, but it can't feel good. I don't know, I guess we'll find out in a minute. Clayton said he was going after blood himself. Now he's got a strap. No, throws it aside. There's another chair. A couple of them, in fact. Oh. got one right where he needs it. Danger still down on the outside. And here comes McClain. Oh, Ganger bleeding as well. And the cheese grater coming back into play. Oh, look at him. Such brutality. But that's what a street fight is all about. He got the fork, I believe. The further open that wound. Thought he was going for the trash can, but decides just to lay in with some right hands. He asked, who's a virgin now? Well, like I said earlier, there's no proof that you're not. I mean, none that I know of, anyway. You know, I can only go by what we're told. Oh, here comes the trash can right over top the cranium. And somehow Ganger's still on his feet. Three in a row and down he goes. Down to the cover, one, two. Oh, only a two count. McClain is really frustrated with himself. Telling Ganger to get up. What's he got in store now? And he's going to end his career. Oh, no, what's he in mind? Oh! Right to the back of the head. And that was right on target. One, two, oh. So close. Ganger is clearly hurting. He is clearly hurting. Now McClain is piling up those chairs. He has something else in mind. Oh, he's gonna badmouth him first. Let him know he's about to end his career. What does he have in mind? Referee's laying the count on him. Maybe McClain doesn't have anything left either. All that blood loss is definitely going to take its toll. Oh, wait a minute, now he's got the trash can on top. Trash can on top of the chairs. Ganger trying desperately to pull himself back up. I don't know, McClain probably should have gone for something. After that elbow to the back of the head, he was about done. Right hand isn't going to do it. Oh, look at the look on his face. Uh-oh. Ganger's had about enough. Blood and all. Oh, a kick out there. And now it looks like Ganger's gonna use the trash can and chair. Third pile driver! Right through the trash can. He got him! Winner of the street fight here tonight. A lot of blood has been lost. But a big victory has been gained. Oh, and he looks so comfortable. This is definitely his element.
Here's the individual we saw earlier who demanded to be part of a ladder match and probably got knocked silly. And listen to the chant of Virgin, Virgin, Virgin. He does not like it. The natural born what? I don't know. It sounded like Daniel Blevins called him the natural born duh. But then again, it's hard to hear over this crowd, over their chants of Virgin, Virgin. Referee's job here is pretty much only to call for the bell and count to three. Marvel on the outside. See, a crutch has also been brought. And there's the bell. Anything goes now. The two individuals, former members of what was known as the conglomerate, now bitter rivals. And they're gonna try to settle it all tonight here at the Purge 2022. As McClain goes head first into that top turnbuckle. Morris delivers several elbows, he comes off and delivers another running elbow. And a running high knee left. What's he got in mind? A drop kick in the corner. And McClain only on his feet because of the corner. Fisherman suplex, but he released him. Bit of nice wrestling still being shown, despite it being a street fight. And now that crutch comes into play. Marble can't wait to hand him something else. Says hit him with this. No, hit him with this. McClain, oh. McClain comes to just to get clobbered again. Just in time to get clobbered. Look at that, Marvel, he continues to throw everything in. Harley can't even keep up with him. Oh, the whole trash can. I think Marvel's having more fun than even Harley is. Definitely more fun than, oh, that plunger now. Like a big turd that he is. And now he's whipping him with that bag. What's in that bag, I wonder? Fans calling for blood. And I think I just might get it. Ah! Oh! Oh, and look at David Marvel. He's loving it. Well, we knew we were going to expect some on the Purge. What else is up the ring? I haven't even seen it all yet. He's got that bag again. Oh, look at that. Now he's got a chain. Nate McLean is known to use a chain himself a time or two. A spit right in his face, and now the chain to the midsection. And to the back. Owie, wow, wow, ouch. Fans calling for blood still. Is the chain still being utilized? Looks like Morris is tying that chain up into the corner to utilize in another. Wait, wait, Marbell's helping him. Well, this is a street fight, so I guess it's. Look at that chain on that turnbuckle. The cone over top there. Oh, wow. He may not even use that chain. Oh, he just pointed to it. Fans saying, do it. Irish whip sends him in. McLean blocks it, however. Oh, wow. Morris goes in himself. And head first into the chain goes Morris. Oh, and McLean trying to get that adrenaline pumping. As the chant of Virgin continues. Morris is still down as he went headfirst into that chain that he himself helped set up. Oh, look at the kisser of McLean. Referee checking. It's tough to tell with all that hair, but it looks like Morris might be spewing the crimson. And now McLean utilizing that chain. And now with that trash can lid across the back. Looking for something else. Now, what's he got now? A kendo stick? Oh, did you hear that? And those things really hurt. It's not just the impact. But when you hit them and that wood closes up and just pulls the skin. It looks like he destroyed that thing. Now Morris in a bad, bad way as that cookie sheet is placed over his face and a drop, oh! Running kick to the side of the head, thought he was going for a drop kick. That would have been even worse. Now a suplex being set up. Oh! Harley in a lot of trouble now. The crowd. Chanting for Morris. And McLean getting a little upset about it. Picks up that crutch. Referee looking. There's really nothing that she can do about it. It is a street fight. Morris desperately trying to fight his way out with that trash can lid. Speaking of trash cans, here it comes into play. But Morris got the feet up and the trash can went right into the face of McLean. Single leg trip, looked like a figure four in a street fight. something you don't see very often in a street fight. Oh, look at that! And using the trash can lid on the knee. And McLean fighting his way out desperately if he can. Three shots did it. These two individuals just totally brutalizing each other. What do you expect out of a street fight? I mean, when you leave a street fight, you definitely leave in worse condition than what you started. Oh, no! Dropped right on that trash can. Look at that. Crushed it down for the cover. This could be it. And somehow Morris managed to kick out. McLean a little furious with himself. He better not wait too long. Morris with a ton of endurance could recover quickly. McLean needs to follow it up somehow. Look at that. Morris already back up to his knees. Wow, did you hear that? Morris back up to his feet now. Oh! A lot more behind Morris's shots. If the two of them continue to fight it out. Cookie sheets. I guess we'll call that one a draw. And now a little back and forth. Oh, it was a good one by Morris. Both men drop down now, but I think Morris is in the better shape of the two. He's got an opportunity. Wow! Clothesline from hell. McLean lucky he didn't hit the back of his head on what's left of that trash can. I know, how odd is that? McLean lucky that he was just the recipient of the clothesline from hell. How often are you lucky for that? And a series of right hands by Morris. And utilizes that cookie sheet again. The adrenaline is pumping now through the body of Harley. Irish whip sends McLean to the corner. Big spine buster. McLean may have hit the back of his head on that cookie sheet in the mat. Morris looking for something. Marbell giving him a chair. Oh, uses it on himself. As he sets the chair up. He's got another chair. He doesn't want that plastic one. He's got a steel chair. That'll do a lot more damage. Fans chanting, kill him. No, we don't need to see that. Wow. McLean landed on his feet in a sleeper hold. How often do you see a sleeper in a street fight? As Marbell slid something into the ring, a cookie sheet. And Morris is utilizing it, trying to fight his way out if he can. McLean has that chair now. Morris says it's over, but he doesn't see that chair. Oh, wow. With all that momentum, went headfirst into the chair. Morris actually lucky that he fell to the outside, because he would have been pinned 1, 2, 3 after that one. McLean following him to the outside. We've seen a lot of action take place on the outside tonight. And again, one of those chains coming into play. Oh, come on, McLean. Come on. This is taking you a little bit too far. Choking him out with that chain wrapped around the post. And there's nothing the referee can do about it. The fans chanting Harley, Harley, but he's going out. The man can't breathe. And I believe Marbell threw the towel in as the referee called for the bell. I mean, there really wasn't any other option. There really was not any other option. Morris was completely helpless. As McLean. Once again, fans, there just really wasn't any other option. As Morris was literally being hung from that steel post by that chain. And had Marbell not thrown in that towel, Morris would still be hanging and hopefully still with us. Referee's checking him out. He's obviously hurting. I said, you leave a street fight in far worse condition than when you came in, but even I wasn't expecting this. There is your winner there, Nate McLean. Well, you won, Nate. That cannot be denied. The winner of the street fight here at Purge 2022 at Odd Bodies Music Room in Dayton, Ohio. Unbelievable, fans. Hopefully, Morris is gonna be okay. Meanwhile, Nate McLean.
He's a coward.
Calling him a coward.
For a scream, man, no, it's not a dream. It's an XVW and they're gonna be thrilling you. They get hardcore, blood covering the floor. They take it out of the ring, they the wrestling kings. When it comes to a show, be ready for the bows. Cause they ain't slow, sit right in the front row. Cause it gets crunk, no